Pro.
Hello, welcome to ADSR Pro with me, Mike Smith. I'm in Cubase 8 Pro and I'm just going to show you a little glitch on the graphic user interface of ChordPad. This was pointed out to me by Jonah Christian at Accent Audio. Be sure to check him out on YouTube. I shall put I shall put the links to Jonah's website, etc., in my little description at the bottom. So please do check those out. So we've got Halion going. I've got a piano on it. So what I'm going to do is Control, Shift, and C, and open up ChordPad. So there you go. You can see as I'm playing the notes with my MIDI keyboard or the mouse, it's playing the note and showing you the chord up here. Now, the issue arises when you press the chord assistant. Now, if you're pressing the chord assistant, I'm using my mouse to do this, but you also happen to press your MIDI keyboard, you can see there now the D has dropped out and is missing. So if I press the D on my MIDI controller keyboard, you can see it's playing the D. You can obviously hear the chord of D minor, but it's not showing you the notes here. Just a little glitch. So you can actually get it to come back if I press my MIDI keyboard. There you go. It comes back again. So I don't know if there's any reasoning behind that or whether it is a glitch. One, it does come back. And, you know, another way of doing it actually is, let's just turn it back on again and pick one of these. See if we can get it to do it again. There we go. So another way of getting it to come back again, literally just close it down. Control Shift C opens it up and it refreshes it. So it must be a little glitch of some sort. Not a massive problem. For me, I've never used ChordPad a great deal as of yet. I'm going to spend some time delving really deep into this and coming up with some tutorials in the near future. But it is a glitch nonetheless, so just thought I'd point that out again, like I say, with thanks to Jonah Christian at Accent Audio for pointing this out. He's done a tutorial on people using Macs, so you can see it in the Mac environment. I'm using Windows 7. So thought it'd be nice to at least show you it in both operating systems, just to rule out the fact that it's not just Windows or Mac. So yeah, there you go. Don't forget, as per usual, subscribe to the channel, and until next time, bye bye.